Hi everyone. Last class we have discussed about the refractive index and how it varies with the different colors, means wavelengths. And also we have discussed about the optical path. So today we discuss actual refraction phenomena and laws of refraction. So if we take two different medium of different densities, this I will take it as rarer and this is a denser one. And if I draw a normal to this one, I will take this as normal N. Okay. So here refractive index I will take as N1 and N2. As I mentioned, this is rarer and denser. So obviously N2 is greater than N1. So when a ray of light incident, instead of traveling in its original path, it will change its direction. So this is what the refracted ray. And this is what the incident ray, and this is I is angle of incident and R is angle of refraction. Okay, so with the help of this diagram we will discuss about the laws of refraction. In first law suggests all about the incident, reflected and normal rays. So what first law suggests that this incident ray, refracted ray, and normal drawn at a point of incidence, all lie in the same plane. Okay. So very important is vector form of first law. How we can write the vector form of refraction? So vector form of this one is, so if you take these two, I will take this incident ray as e cap is what? Unit vector in the direction of incident ray, and this I will take it as r cap. This is what? Unit vector in the direction of refracted ray, and normal I will take it as n cap. Okay. So if I take cross product of E and N, if I take E cap cross N cap, where will be the resultant? Resultant is perpendicular to both E and N. That means it is going to be here. Okay. This is what your resultant. Now where is refracted ray? Refracted ray is here. What is the angle between refracted ray and this resultant of E cross N? They are perpendicular to each other, they are 90 degree to each other. So if I take dot product of these two, E cross N dot R cap, E cap cross N cap is what? Perpendicular to R cap, means here angle between R cap and resultant of E and N is what? 90 degrees. So when in the dot product, cos 90 is what? 0. So result is going to be 0. This is what the vector form. If I go for second law, so this is what's important. So second law is all about the Snell's law. So what it suggests? Snell's law suggests that sine of angle of incidence to the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to sine of angle of refraction is equal to a refractive index. This is what? Relative refractive index. Refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. Okay. So I can also write it as sine I divided by sine R equals to. So can I write this relative refractive index in terms of absolute refractive index? Absolute refractive index will become what? I can write it as N2 divided by N1. So N1 sine I equals to N2 sine R. Okay. So this is what the second law, Snell's law. I can represent this in different form also. N1, if here velocity is V1, can I write N1 as C by V1 and N2 as C by V2? So N1 I will replace by C by V1 sine I equals to C by V2 sine R. So C will get cancelled. I can also write it as sine I by V1 equals to sine R divided by V2. This is also you can use, or else I can also represent n1 as lambda naught by lambda 1 and n2 as lambda naught by lambda 2. Lambda naught is what? Wavelength in the vacuum or in the free space. So similarly, I will substitute here. What I can substitute? Lambda naught by lambda 1 sin I equals to lambda naught by lambda 2 sin R. So what I can write? I can write sin I by lambda 1 equals to sin R divided by lambda 2. So you can use this formula also. So different forms of the Snell's law. If I want to write this vector form of Snell's law, how I can write the vector form of Snell's law? So vector form of Snell's law, I can write what it says, n1 sin r equals to n2 sin r. Okay, so n1 sin I, it is the angle between e cap and n cap. Can I write sin I as e cap cross n cap equals to n2 sin r? Is what sin r is? Angle between unit vector refracted ray and normal. So I can write it as r cap cross n cap. Okay, so this is what the vector form of second law of refraction. Okay, so if suppose there are more than two medium, suppose it is having the number of medium 1, 2, 3. Okay, if a ray of light comes from here, so what will happen? It incident at an angle of say r. Okay, so here refractive index is n1, here n2, this is n3, this is n4, this is what, n5. Okay, so it will refract, and that we can take it as r1. Okay, if this is r1, this angle of incidence is also what? R1. So again, this will refract here. If this is r1, this I will take as r2. If this is r2, this angle of incidence is also what? R2. So here it is r3, I will take it as. If that is r3, this is also going to be r3. So finally, this is what? R4. Okay. So if I apply this Snell's law for each two mediums, so what will happen? Here I can write it as n1 sin I equals to n2 sin r1. Okay. Now I will take n2 and n3. For n2 and n3, angle of incidence is r1 and angle of refraction is r2. So n2 sin r1 is equals to n3 sin r2. Okay. So now for n3 and n4, n3 sin r2, n3 sin r2 is equals to n4 sin r3. Okay. So similarly, n4 and n5, n4 sin r3 is equals to n5 sin r4. Okay. Now look at these four. N1 sin r is equals to n2 sin r1. N2 sin r1 is equals to what? N3 sin r2. That means these two are equal. Similarly, if this is equals to me, this is equals to this one. So what I can directly write it as, n1 sin I is equals to n2 sin r1 is equals to n3 sin r2 equals to n3 sin r2 is equals to n4 sin r3, and that is equals to n5 sin r4. Means all are equal. If you want between any two medium, you can easily calculate. You can equate n1 sin I equals to what? n3 sin r2. Okay. So directly what I can write, if light is refracting through a different mediums, so directly you can write n1 sin I is equals to n5 sin r4. So you can write it like this. Okay. Or in general, what I can write, you can simply apply n i, refractive index of incident medium, sine or angle of incident equals to, this is what refractive index of emergent medium, where it is emerging outside, okay. So into sine r, not r, I will take it as e. E is what angle of emergence. So generally I can write it like this also, okay. So this is what the Snell's law for when there are combination of mirrors. For example, suppose there are different mediums, okay. If suppose there are different mediums, I will take this as N1, N2, N3, N4. A ray of light incident here, okay, say angle of incident R. Now it is refracting here, so it is emerging, it is coming here. So this is what angle of emergence, okay. So in between there are so many refractions, so to show that properly, better I will take it here, okay. So this is what I will take it, this is what normal. So this is what angle of emergence, okay. This is what I will take it as N5. Now what will be the question? Question is, say, if incident ray and refracted ray, if incident ray and refracted ray are parallel, then relation between N1 and N5, relation between N1 and N5, they can use the options like N1 is equals to 2N2, sorry N5, or N1 is equals to N2, or N2 is equals to 2N1, or N1 by N2 equals to 1/2. So they can give anything. So what will be our answer? So we can directly apply this point. So what I can apply here is N1 sin I is equals to N5 sin what E. What they mention in the question, they mention incident ray and refracted ray are parallel. Incident ray and refracted ray parallel means angle of emergence is equals to angle of incidence. So I equals to E. If I equals to E, what will happen? N1 will become equals to what? N2. So this is what your answer. Okay. So N1 is equals to N2. So this is how we can take use of Snell's law. We'll take more examples. Now many times they ask the questions on the deviation also. If there are two mediums, say N1 and N2 refractive indices, and this is the normal, okay. If a ray of light incident from here with the angle of incidence say I, if N2 is greater than N1, if N2 is greater than N1, that means N1 is rarer and this is what denser, okay. If this is the case, so the ray of light after refraction will bend towards the normal when light travel from rarer to denser. So it will come here. This is what angle of refraction. So there is some deviation. How much deviation has taken place? This is what the deviation delta. How we can find this delta? This total is what? This total is I only. So I, and this is also I. So deviation, what you can write? I minus R will give you the deviation. Okay. Suppose a ray of light is coming here, okay. So if it deviates here, so delta the deviation. If you take this as angle of incidence as 60 degree, and this is what N1 you can take it as air medium, N2 you can take it as glass, that is 3/2, or simply you can take it as root 3 or whatever. So what will happen? So 1 sin 60 equals to root 3. So sin r, angle of refraction they want to give. So this will become what? Root 3/2 equals to root 3 sin r. So this will get cancelled. So r will become what? 30 degree. So r is 30. If r is 30 degree, so deviation is what? I minus r. I is 60, r is 30. So you will get deviation as 30 degree. Okay, so this is when a ray of light travels from radar to denser medium. If situation is reverse, if ray of light is traveling from denser to rarer, if it is traveling from denser to rarer, this is N2 and this is N1. So N2 is greater than N1 again. Okay, so here it will not bend towards the normal, it will bend away from the normal. Okay, so this is what going to be your R. This is what going to be your R. Okay, so now deviation is what? Deviation is this one. So this is what the deviation. So how we can represent deviation now? So deviation is equals to, so R minus R, this is, this angle is what? This angle is I only. So this total is R. So R minus I will give you what? Deviation. Okay. So similarly, if you take this example only, so if you take this example only, if ray of light traveling from here, so refractive index here is root 3. So what will happen? Root 3 sine, take this as 30 degree, sine 30 equals to, so here it is A, so what will happen? 1 sine R. So root 3 sine 30 is 1 by 2 equals to what? Sine R. So R equals to what? R equals to 60 degree. So delta equals to R minus R, 60 degree minus 30 degree, deviation will be what? 30 degree. Okay. So this is what when there are medium separated with the different densities. Suppose instead of this one, if there is a sphere, okay, if there is a sphere, a ray of light incident here, say at an angle of 60 degree, okay, this is what the 60 degree, okay, this is what A, this is what say refractive index of sphere is root 3. Now if they ask the deviation, a ray of light will come here and this will deviate towards the normal instead of going here. So it will deviate towards the normal. Again, here it is normal. So what will happen? It will bend away from the normal. So instead of going here, it is bending away from the normal. So this is what the path of the ray. Now if they ask the deviation, two times deviation has taken place. One deviation is here, that is delta 1, another deviation is here, that is delta 2. Okay, so total deviation d equals to delta 1 plus delta 2. For that we have to find delta 1 and delta 2. For delta 1 and delta 2, to find delta 1, refractive index of this medium is 1 sine 60 is equals to root 3 sine R we don't know. So sine 60 is what? Root 3 by 2, root 3 sine R. So R equals to what? R equals to 30 degree. So delta 1 is what? Ray is traveling from rarer to denser medium. When light ray is traveling from rarer to denser, so it is I minus R. Okay? It is I minus R. So 60 minus 30 will give you the 30. Okay? So similarly here, if this is 30 degree, obviously this is also going to be what? 30 degree. So root 3 sine 30 is equals to, here refractive index is 1, sine R. Okay, here angle of refraction R. So root 3 sine 30 is 1 by 2, so equals to sine R. So again R is equals to what? R is going to be 60 degree. Okay, here ray of light is traveling from denser to rarer. So from denser to rarer it is R minus I. So delta 2 is equals to R is 60 degree minus 30. It is going to be 30. Okay. So if you look at the direction of deviation, here also it is in clockwise direction. Here also it is in clockwise direction. So we can add it. When you add it, it will become what? 30 degree plus 30 degree. So deviation is what? Net deviation is 60, because delta 1 is 30, delta 2 is also 30. Okay, so this is how we can get it. But sometimes they will ask the refractive index only. When they ask refractive index only, this method may not work, because you don't know refractive index also. If you don't know what your angle of refraction also, then it is difficult. I will go with a general method, one general formula we can derive here. Suppose, suppose there is a sphere, okay, so this is what's the diameter, so you can take this as normal also, okay. So if a ray of light incident here, say with the angle of incident alpha, so it will go in this direction, this is what say beta. So again here, so where it will come here, okay. So this is what beta, so emergent you can take it as gamma, okay. So if this is the case, so what I can write this is what air medium, this is say refractive index n. So 1 sin alpha equals to n sin beta, okay. So you got one equation, that is sin alpha equals to n sin beta, equation number 1, okay. So similarly, so what you can write here, angle of incidence is what, beta. So n sin beta equals to, this is what, gamma, so 1 sin gamma. So what will happen here, so you can take this as equation number 2. From 192, can I equate sin alpha equals to sin gamma? That means what? That means alpha equals to gamma. Okay. So what is deviation at first place? Deviation at first place is alpha minus beta. Deviation at second place, it is delta 2 equals to actually gamma minus beta. But gamma equals to what? Alpha. So what will happen? Again it is alpha minus beta 1. So what is net deviation? Net deviation is delta 1 plus delta 2. That is alpha minus beta plus alpha minus beta. So net deviation is equals to 2 times alpha minus beta. Remember, this is what going to help somewhere. Okay. So now if I use this method to solve a problem. Suppose there is a sphere. Suppose you are having a sphere. Okay, so here, refractive index we don't know. Okay, so angle of incident you can take it as 60 degree. Okay, a ray of light emerging somewhere here parallel to the normal. Okay, it is coming here. Okay. Means parallel to x axis or normal, if it is coming here. So what you can take or you can write here, if this is the case, they are asking what is the refractive index of sphere. Okay, now what is the deviation here? Deviation they have not given, but deviation we can find it here. If this is 60 degrees, so what is going to be here? 60 degrees. Okay, if this is 60, a ray of light is going here only. So net deviation is what? Net deviation is 60 degree only. If net deviation is 60 degree, we know that d equals to 2 times alpha minus beta. Okay. So d is 60 degree equals to 2 into alpha is what? Alpha is 60 minus beta. So minus beta. Beta we don't know. So what we can write here? It will become 30 degree. So 30 equals to 60 minus beta. So divided to means 30. So beta will come this side. So 60 minus 30. This will become 30. So beta you got it as 30. Alpha already you know here. Alpha is already 60 degree. Can you write n equals to sine alpha divided by sine beta? So what is sine alpha? Sine alpha is sine 60 divided by sine 30. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. And sine 30 is 1 by 2, this 2 will get cancelled, so refractive index will become what? Root 3, that is what we have taken here. Okay. So, with the help of that method, we can find the refractive index easily, if we know the deviation. Okay. So, now we will discuss about the sifting. When a ray of light travels from rarer to, denser to rarer medium, suppose this is medium N1 and this is medium N2. Suppose if this is the water, okay, and this is air. This is air and this is water. Suppose there is a fish. So what will happen? A ray of light travel from here, from the fish, okay. So at this point, okay, since it is traveling from denser to rarer, so n1 is greater than n2. It is traveling from denser to rarer, so what will happen? It will bend away from the normal. So this is what angle of refraction, this is what angle of incidence. So suppose what will happen if this is the normal over here. So this ray will reach this point, not exactly object. So for a person who is looking from outside, so what will happen? Fish seems to be here, okay? But actual depth is here. Actual distance of fish, I will take it as actual depth as d, okay? So, but he is not seeing the position of the actual position of the fish. Instead, he is seeing the apparent position of the fish. So this is what we take it as the apparent depth d dash, okay? So what is the shift? This much shift has taken place. This is what the shift. So due to this shift, the person seems to be fish is going to be here, okay? So now, how much shift has taken place, or how to find the apparent depth, or how to find the real depth? If this is r, this is going to be r. If this total is r, this total is going to be r. So this is what going to be r. I will take this as x. Okay. Now, what I can write here is, we know that n1 sine I is equals to n2 sine r. Okay, so n1 for small angle, for small angles I and r, you can write n1 tan I equals to n2 tan r. Okay, so n1, what is tan I from this triangle? From this triangle, tan I is x divided by, so what you can write, x by total d. So x by d equals to n2. What is tan r? Tan r x divided by d dash. So x by d dash. So x should get cancelled. So n1 by n2 equals to, what you can write, d divided by d dash. Okay. So this is what the general formula. I am not going to give 2-3 formula when the light out from denser to rarer or rarer to denser. Only remember this point. This is what refractive index of the ray from where it is coming. Refractive index of ray where it is emerging. This is what real depth. This is what the apparent depth. Suppose this is water of refractive index n and this is air of refractive index 1. So what will happen? N1 is what? N. N2 is 1. So d divided by d dash. So n equals to what? D by d dash. Okay. That is real depth. Real depth divided by apparent depth. Okay. So this is what going to be the formula to find the refractive index when object is in denser medium. Now what is the shift? Shift is equals to real depth minus apparent depth. So real depth is what? Real depth is d minus apparent depth d dash. So d minus d dash, can you write d by n? So d divided by n. So formula will become d into 1 minus 1 divided by n. Okay. So this is for ray of light traveling from denser to rarer. Instead of that one, if light is coming from rarer to denser, if light is coming from rarer to denser, what will happen? If light is coming from rarer to denser, so this will become, n1 will become what? 1. So n1 will become 1 divided by n2 will become n equals to what? D divided by d dash. Now n will become what? N will become d dash divided by d. So n equals to apparent depth divided by real depth. Okay. So when ray of light travels from rarer to denser, obviously apparent depth is more than real depth. Suppose if a bird is here, okay, a ray of light comes from the bird. So what will happen here? It will bend towards the normal. So it will bend towards the normal. So when we extend this one, this is what the apparent height of the bird. So this is what real depth or real height. This is what apparent depth or apparent height. So now, your apparent depth is more than real depth. So that is why apparent depth divided by real depth will give you what? Refractive index. If you want to find the shift here, so shift is equals to apparent depth minus real depth. So d dash minus d. So d dash is what? D dash is, so can I write n into d? So n into d, okay, minus. So d you can write as it is. So it will become n minus 1 into d. So this is what the shift when a ray of light travel from rarer to denser medium. Okay. So suppose if we take an example. Okay. So a coin is going to be here, or a fish is going to be here. Okay. And a bird is going to be here. Take a bird is there. Bird is there. Say at say some 20 meter distance, and this is there say at some 30 distance. So now what will happen if this bird is looking at this one, a ray of light, okay, so this will come from here. If this is a fish, okay, so fish is there in the water, you can take, so you can take 1.3 as the refractive index. Now what will happen, because of denser medium, bird is going to see the fish at this point. Now what they will ask, what is the distance between the fish and bird as observed by the bird, not actual. Actual is 30, okay. So now what we can get, we have to find this apparent depth. If you find apparent depth, you can easily find distance between bird and fish. So as seen by bird, I say that is going to take the apparent depth. Now can I write, ray of light is going from here, n1 by n2 equals to what we have? We have d by d dash. n1 by n2 equals to d by d dash. N1 is what? 1.3, 1.3 means water, 1.3 means you can write it as say 4/3, okay. So n1 is 4/3, n2 is air medium, so 1. So d is what? Real depth, 30 they have given, equals to d dash. So this is what the d dash. Okay, we want d dash. So d dash is equals to, so 30/4 into 3. So what we will get? We can get it as 90/4. Okay. Now from here to here it is 20. From here to here, how much it is? It is 90/4. So total distance between bird and fish as seen by the bird is, so distance is equal to 20 plus 90/4. Okay. So this is what? 80 plus 90/4. So total is 170/4. This is what, how we can calculate the different depth or distance between the bird and fish, or they may ask the actual depth or refractiveness, whatever. So we'll take one example on the shifting. So if suppose there is a cube, okay, if there is a cube of glass, made up of glass, you can take it as, and having the side say 30 centimeter. So what is the refractive index? Refractive index is not given. Refractive index is not given. So but they are given something else. There is an object or there is a point inside. Okay. When you see it from this side, it is looking at distance 12 centimeters. Okay. When you see it from this side, it is looking at distance say 8 centimeters. Okay. But what is the actual distance? Actual distance is 30 centimeters. Now what they are asking, what is the exact position or where will be the object inside the cube? Okay. If this is the case, how we can calculate this one? If refractive index is given, easily you can calculate, but refractive index is also not given. So we can use our normal shift formula. We can use, if you are seeing from this side, a ray of light will come from here. So if I apply, If I apply n1 by n2 equals to d by d dash, so n1 I will take it as n, so here it is a, n2 I will take it as 1, equals to d, real depth we don't know where it is, maybe it is here, I will take it as x, so real depth x divided by apparent depth 12. So what we can get, we got it as x equals to, so d by d dash, so it is 12n. No, I will take it as n equals to x divided by 12. Okay. So similarly, if you see from this side, what will happen? N1 by n2 equals to again d by d dash. So n1 is what? N, n2 is 1. So d is what? D is from this side it is x. So from this side, what is the real depth? Real depth is real length of edge is 30. So this will become 30 minus 6. So I will write it as 30 minus x whole divided by d dash, they are given 8. So d dash they are given 8. So what you got here? Again you got it in 30 minus x divided by 8. Okay. So take these two equations 1 and 2. So you can write x by n equals to 12, equation number 3. Another is 30 minus x by n equals to 8. This is 4. Add equation 3 and 4. If you add 3 and 4, what you will get? You will get it as x by n plus 30 minus x by n. 30 minus x divided by n equals to 12 plus 8. This will become what? 20. Okay. So now, and you can take on that side. So what will happen? X plus 30 minus x equals to 20n. X will get cancelled. So n will become what? 3 by 2. 3 by 2 means 1.5. That means it is a glass. The given cube is made up of glass. We got refractive index. But they are not asking refractive index. What they are asking? They are asking where will be the object inside the cube. That means actual position of the object. If you want from this side, what is the actual position? Actual position is, so how we can get? We can get it from here. N equals to x by 12. So x equals to n into 12. So n we got it as 3 by 2. So 3 by 2 into 12. So this will become what? 80 centimeter from this side. Say from side A. From side B, what will be the distance? From side B, distance will be, so n equals to 30 minus x. Sorry. Simply that you can take it as x dash equals to 30 minus x. So 30 minus 80. So simply you can get it as 12. Okay. So this is how we can take use of normal shifting formula to find the actual depth or refractive index of. We will take one more example where we can take the combination of both mirror and whatever shifting. Okay. Because this is the container having the water. Okay. So this is what containing the water. Okay. So this I will take it as instead of a plane. Suppose if this is the something convex mirror. Okay. Convex mirror of focus and say 20 centimeter. There is a fish at the center of this one. There is a fish at center of this one. Center means from here to here it is 20 centimeter, again from surface to here it is 20 centimeter. Okay. Now a person is seeing from outside. Okay. If person is seeing the object from outside, fish from outside, what they are asking is, what is the distance between images seen by the eyes? What is the distance between images? Between images as seen by observer or as seen by eye. Now how we can use? They are asking distance between images. Distance between images means obviously there will be two images. So if this is a real depth, okay, say real depth is 20, a ray of light will go and it will refract. So this is what going to be one image due to shifting. Okay, so another is a ray of light come from here. Okay, so it will reflect. It will reflect. Okay, so this is what going to be another image. Here is one another image. Okay, now this distance too you can find. So this how we can find this one. This you can find. This is water means refracted means is what 4/3. So for this image, for first image, right? N1 by N2 equals to d by d dash. N1 is what 4/3 divided by N2 is a equals to real depth is what 20. 20 divided by d dash. So d dash equals to 20 by 4 into 3. So 4 5s are, this will become what 15 centimeter. So object is there at 15 centimeter below the surface. Okay, from here to here it is 15 centimeter. Now find this one. First for that we have to find the what is the distance of object from the mirror. So how we can write here, f is 20. Okay, ray of light is traveling in this direction, so f is going to be positive only. What is object distance? Object distance is 20 but minus 20. So u equals to minus 20. So v is what? 1 by v plus 1 by u equals to 1 by f. So 1 by v is equals to 1 by 20. So 1 by minus 20 will become 1 by plus 20. So v is going to be what? This is what? 2 by 20. So v is going to be 10 centimeter. Okay. Now, what is the real height of this one? Or what is the real depth of the fish now? This object. Okay. Here refraction is taking place. From here to here it is 40. Again this 10. So its real depth is 40 plus 10. That is 50. Now you apply N1 by N2 equals to real depth divided by apparent depth. So N1. What is N1 here? N1 is going to be again 4/3. So it is 4/3 divided by 1 equals to d is 50 now. 50 divided by d dash we want to calculate. So d dash equals to 50 divided by 4 into 3. That is 150 by 4. That is what? The apparent position. Now what they are asking? They are asking distance between these two images. Okay. Now, so what is the total apparent position of this object? Apparent position of this object is this one. I will take this d double s. So distance between these two is this total, that is d double s, this d dash. So this is what? So distance between images is equals to d double dash minus d dash. So d double dash is what? 150 by 4 minus d dash we got it as 50. Okay, so 150 minus 15 4, it is 60 divided by 4. So it is going to be 90 by 4 centimeter. So this is what distance between the images. Okay, so like that we can apply this formula, that is N1 by N2 equals to d by d dash. Okay, whether ray travel from regular to denser or denser to regular, just go with this formula. You can calculate the N1 or N2 or d or d dash. Okay, so in next class we will discuss about the glass lamp, how the shifting will take place in the glass lamp. Okay.